friends, myself Anurag Chauhan from Imperial Institute, Kannauj. Today in this lecture, we are going to discuss on Thomas Gray, well known for his famous elegy, Elegy Written in Country Churchyard. First, we will talk about his family background. Thomas Gray was born in Cobham Hill, London on 26th of December 1716. His father's name was Philip Gray, who was an exchange broker. He was not a good husband. He was abusive, ill-tempered and wife-beater. He used to beat his wife. Thomas Gray's mother was Dorothy Gray. She was a religious lady. She was particularly fond of Thomas Gray because Thomas Gray was the fifth and the only surviving child out of 12 children of his parents. And his mother, Dorothy Gray, left her husband and began to live with young Thomas Gray away from him. Because she was fed up with his irritated behavior. And after a few years, Dorothy Gray arranged 8-year-old Thomas Gray to go off school where her brothers were masters. At Eton College, he met with Richard West, Thomas Aston and Horace Walpole. Horace Walpole was the son of Prime Minister Robert Walpole and Richard West, later on appointed a Lord Chancellor of Ireland. And in 1734, he joined St. Peter's College, and after Peter's College, he went to Pembroke College, Cambridge University. When he went there, he found the curriculum of Cambridge University dull. So he had little interest in it. And in 1738, he left Cambridge University with the intention of attempting law. After leaving Cambridge University in 1738, the very next year, he accompanied his old friend Horace Walpole on his grand tour of Europe. He visited notably Scotland, Alps Mountains and many other historical and ancient places. He admired Alps Mountain and wrote all his notable impressions in his diary. Both Thomas Gray and Horace Walpole were parted in Tuscany because Horace Walpole wanted to attend fashionable parties while Thomas Gray wanted to visit all the antiquities. They were reconciled after a few letters. After some year, Thomas Gray was appointed a professor at Cambridge University. He spent most of his life in the University of Cambridge. He remained a bachelor whole life because he never married. His mother was very affectionate to him and she suffered a lot for him. So Thomas Gray was deeply attached to his mother. He refused poet laureateship in 1757. Gray was ferocious leader. He was so hungry for reading other books because whenever he got any chance, he never missed it for reading other books, and he was a man of great learning. And ultimately, we can say that Thomas Gray was not only a man of great learning of his time, but also a poet of considerable merit. He wrote little because he was one of least productive poets. But whatever he wrote was of excellent quality. He started his career with the tradition of Dryden and Pope. He was deeply influenced by classical poetry. He admired Dryden. But he is regarded one of the chief precursors of romantic movement because he had love of nature and profound humility, victim of sentiments, and all these qualities are of romanticism, which is found in his poetry, because all these qualities were in him. So he could not restrain all these qualities of romanticism. So we can find it in his poetry. By observing all these qualities of romanticism, we can see that he anticipated the age of romance. Thomas Gray had tendency to melancholy in his early years, and premature death of his best friend Richard West deepened it. So students, now we will discuss about his work. Say Thomas Gray began his literary career as a poet in 1742, mainly after the death of his best friend Richard West. Although he wrote little, yet he is regarded as foremost English language poet of mid 18th century. Gray came to be known as one of the graveyard poets. Gray considered his two Pindaric odes, The Progress of Poesy and The World, his best works. Ode on a Distant Prospect of Eton was his Horatian ode, and Ode on the Death of a Favorite Cat was one of his light verses, because it is written on the death of Horace Walpole's cat. His other works are The Fatal Sister, The Descent of Odin, The Ode in Spring, Hymn to Adversity, The Triumph of On, and The Hymn to Ignorance, Ode on the Pleasure Arising from Vicissitude. And if we talk about his masterpiece Elegy Written in Country Churchyard, it is believed that Thomas Gray started writing this poem in the graveyard of St. Giles Parish Church. Remember, Gray started writing his masterpiece Elegy Written in Country Churchyard in the graveyard of St. Giles Parish Church in Stockbridge, Buckinghamshire, London. In 1742, he completed this masterpiece. It took 8 years to complete this poem, and it was published by Robert Dodsley in the February 1751. Within 2 years, 11 editions were published, and it was translated in many other languages, including Greek and Latin. It was a sensation when it was published. Its reflective and stoic tone was greatly admired. It is a poem that is most widely read and gives delight all over the world. Okay. I hope you like this video. If you have any problem related to this topic, so ask in comment section. Subscribe this channel for more tutorial videos, and don't forget to press bell icon to get notified time.